Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be modeling an icosahedron in SketchUp. Alright, so I started this video and I was going to make a geodesic dome or a buckyball, and what I realized is that a lot of people are starting their own tutorials with icosahedrons, but nobody shows you how to make an icosahedron. So I figured, hey, I'll do that before I do this, and this is actually based off of a SketchUp tutorial from the SketchUp Skill Builder. So kudos to those guys. I'll link to that in the description below. But I figured I'd have a different spin on it. Maybe you'd learn it differently when I do it. So I figured I'd do it anyway. But yeah, so we're going to start here with the polygon tool. You can see here I have side selected. An icosahedron is a 20-sided shape where all of the sides are triangular. They're all equal triangles. So to do that, we're going to start with a triangle. We're going to make sure we're in the green axis here. I'm just going to make a shape. I'm going to flip this face so that the white face is up. Make that a component and just call this face. So all of the edges are exactly the same, so we can keep them the same. And then I'm just going to scale this so that the face here is 1 foot. Just so that we have a point of reference. I'm going to choose the polygon tool again. And the shape that makes this up is a pentagon, so we're going to select 5 for this pentagon. I'm just going to make a shape going again in the green direction. Select this shape, make it a group, then go into this group, select the tape measure tool, choose our line that's parallel, select that, and we want that to be 1 foot, so that we now have the pentagon is the same, has sides that are the same width as the triangle we made. So I'm just going to move this so that the triangle is here. Now the thing we want to do is make a vertical line at our axis here, so it's also the center point of our pentagon. I'm going to choose the arc tool here, not the 2-point or 3-point arc, just the or the pi. We're just going to choose the regular arc tool. And then I'm going to hit the right arrow key here to lock to the red axis. I'm going to choose this as my center point for my arc, and then choose the triangle here, and then I'll start to draw an arc. And you can see that we get an intersection point right there. So what we want to do then is choose Q for the rotate tool, hit the right arrow, and then rotate this triangle up until it intersects. You may have to zoom in. I'm using the mouse wheel here to zoom in. It looks like something's not quite right. This should be right there, but it's not. So let's try that again. Again here. And just make sure that we are selecting that point. Choose this again. You just have to be careful. I chose something different. There we go. That looks better. Okay, so now we have that arc. You just want to be a little bit careful about how you do that. Now we don't actually need this pentagon anymore. So I'm going to delete it. I'm going to hit Q for the rotate tool. Hit the plus arrow so I can stay locked to that blue axis. Choose this here. Now you can see I'm rotating, but I'm going to hit Control to make a copy, and then rotate that so that it's here. Hit the asterisk symbol. You can also use X for multiply, but I prefer asterisks. And then hit 4. So I have 4 of these guys. And then you may just want to double check, make sure you don't have an extra face at your starting line. So now we have this guy. Looks pretty good. Now what we're going to do is select these 3 faces. Choose the green axis. Just rotate that down. Blue. Just rotating this around. And then we want to go to the red. See if this works. So there we go. We have that shape. So I just did three little rotates there to try to get that shape. Since they're all these are equal, I'm just trying to get that to move around so that we all the angles are the same and everything. So you just have to rotate so that they all line up. So we have this trifecta going on. And then I'm just going to take this guy, these two, and actually, let me take all three. Select the midpoint. I hit Q there to do the rotate, and then we're going to rotate again. Hit Control. Actually, I just need these two. Right, so here, hit that Control times two. Nope, so you can actually do that again times three. No, so times four. That's money. So we have that. I think we have a duplicate face there, so I'm just going to delete it. And then come in with this top piece. And this should be fairly simple. I'm going to copy that down. Select all my groups. Flip along blue direction, so it'll just reverse that. And then we just want to make sure that this is in the center, so I'm just going to put it here and then move it down. So I'm just holding shift here to keep that. I'm going to hit Q for rotate, choose this midpoint, also press the plus arrow there, and then we're just going to rotate to here. So that's our icosahedron. Pretty simple. And because of the way that I built this, you can actually do some cool stuff. If I want to, since these are all components and that's how we constructed it, we can actually make some voids if we want. I'm choosing the offset tool here. Kind of cool. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.